to my channel. If you recall the last time of my sharing, how did I get involved in the event industry and how did I leave my job? Back in the late 90s, the business of event management that the company that I joined in was very good there. But what we didn't predict was during the financial crisis that we weren't prepared. So from big business become small business, as the manager employed myself, I have to think of a lot of strategy to help the company to sustain this business. Still, we couldn't pull through. So what happened was my salary was being paid 1 month once, become 2 months once, then become 3 months once, then eventually no salary for that whole 2 years I was struggling in and out of this. And my car was all time being reprocessed. Until the state that the reprocessor and myself become friends. And I was really fed up. I mean, I couldn't go on. Until one morning when I wake up, I open my wallet, I see I only left with 10 ringgit. Yes, you hear it right, I left with 10 ringgit. I asked myself that moment, am I supposed to pump petrol and go to work now? Or am I supposed to use that 10 ringgit to have my breakfast? And my decision at that moment was to pump petrol to go to office. I tendered my resignation letter, and my boss said to me, yes, I would like to go with 3 conditions. The first condition is I cannot tell the customer that I have left the company. Second condition is I cannot do events for this company. The third condition was I have to go back to the company that I used to work with to service the customer and also do their events if they come back to the company. And I agreed because I was desperate. And after leaving the company, I started looking for a freelance job. I started doing a lot of events in China, Malaysia, Indonesia and Singapore. During my freelance day, money was good. I get to travel and see the world again. But however, what I didn't achieve was the sense of security. Where am I supposed to go from being a freelancer? So one day, my best friend, Adrian, she came and see me, asked me, hey, why don't we partner? Let's do something. So we came up with something. We wanted to do body shampoo business. Okay. After much consideration, Adrian and myself realized no money, no business experience, we cannot find the big market. We decided to let go the business, let go this dream. So what do I do next? Adrian told me, do what you know best. So I decided, no more freelancing, start on my own. Early 2000, I started Epic Evolution, my first event company. It was not an easy road. I've got no customer. Of all the 3 promises that I promised to my boss, I have to keep to my word. I start doing cold calling. I go to TM Telecom Malaysia to get the yellow pages, to flip pages by pages. After 6 months of flipping the pages and cold calling, finally I have my first sales. And that was IOI. Thank you IOI for giving me the first opportunity. Events start coming in, sales was good, and I'm ready to open my second and my third. I have Malacca office, I have Klang Valley office. Things was fantastic. During the financial crisis come 2010, I thought I was ready. Event management part is running well. Now all I needed was a second income. So I opened a restaurant business. So Mama Yip restaurant came about. We are specialized in porridge, seafood porridge. The bad news is within 3 months, the business, we shut down the business and I lost 100,000 cash. What I found out about Mama Yip, the lesson is having no passion for cooking is the one that leads to my failure. And running a restaurant takes up a lot of my time. I have to be there all the time to make sure things are moving well in terms of operation. So what happened after Mama Yip closed? Then I tell myself, okay, since my event business is doing well, I shall go back there and focus. But what I didn't realize was during the financial crisis in the 2010, it also hit the event industry. We start losing jobs. Customers couldn't afford the luxury anymore. They couldn't afford to pay us. So I was telling myself, if that's the case, what should I do? So we came up with a lot of strategy, keeping only the good performing staff who are willing to go through the thick and thin. We did rebranding, we chose our segment, we chose what kind of customers to target. So things was going well and we can maintain and sustain even up to today. Back to this year, 2017. This is the year that gave me a lot of thoughts. I asked myself, I've been through so much in life, ups and downs. You know, what is the purpose of my life? Business part, it is doing well. Other businesses, I have people to manage. When I went back to Johor Bahru one day, that was the second encounter I had with my dad, that he almost died. Now, my dad is bedridden. I asked myself, am I supposed to grow old like that? What is the meaning and purpose behind all? I was really desperate, really down. I see no meaning, despite having money, despite having a successful career. One night, when I was telling myself maybe I should just stop everything, I received a private message from this lady. She is not somebody close to me. She's an acquaintance. Matter of fact, she is my competitor. After I read the private message, it really boosted me up. It was a booster at that moment when I needed it most. I know what I want from then onwards. I tell myself, I would like to leave a legacy behind. And I'd like to share with people of my success formula and secret. I'd like to see more younger generation to be successful. In whether it's an event industry or in any chosen path that they have chosen for themselves. That's how the program of Rock Like a Star comes into the picture. So to all friends outside, if I can do it, so can you. Don't give up.
Hello, thank you for watching. For those of you who just joined me, please remember to leave a like and subscribe to my channel. And follow me through Facebook and Instagram. See you soon. Bye.